easy decision. I have very few skills at playing. I tried. I've learned how to ice skate. I could not stick handle, could not shoot. I was the last guy picked every time. I could not play. It was an issue of skill. Couldn't do it.
Yeah, that's what I'm assuming.
Usually 13 minutes.
Yeah, because that's what the Furies were 13.
Your drop, let's get it going.
What we do is, I do go to a seminar once a year. There's very little going on in the seminar in the way of ice skating. There is ice skating involved. You go through drills, and instructors are there. Some of the instructors at these seminars are NHL officials and AHL officials. Broken nose, cracked ribs, sliced hand. I think that's it. I think that's enough. I don't need any more injuries.
Guys, keep the sticks down. Sticks coming up to hit me. That's not fun. Keep the sticks down on these face offs. Have a good game, guys.
You have to make a signal if there's a penalty.
Two blue, there's minor.
A different
flicking.
Hand or arm signal for every penalty in the game, with one exception, actually. If there is a penalty for too many men on the ice, and there is no hand signal for that. So you pretty much just have to skate up to the scorekeeper and the coach and say, hey, coach, you had too many. I need a guy in the box. For players, if it's youth hockey, you talk to them. You kind of tell them, settle down, relax. You're out here to have a good time. It's only a minor penalty. It's nothing big. It's no big deal. You can talk to the players at the youth level. Coaches and parents, they sometimes feel, especially coaches, they feel like they have, like it's part of their job to challenge you or to defend their players' actions.
We don't want anybody sitting. We want you out here playing hockey, having fun, okay? Play with respect for each other, for your teammates.
Well, referees, many people don't know this. We wear shin pads, just like players. We wear a girdle, which is protects you from your kidneys down to your knees. Then the shin pads take over from your knees down to your skates. So we're fully protected from the kidneys down. And of course, we have to wear a helmet. Now, what we don't wear that the players wear is we don't wear shoulder pads. We don't wear mouth guards or cages because we need to get the whistle in and out of our mouth and be verbal. And we don't wear gloves. So that does pose some danger when I drop the puck at a faceoff. That's one of the most dangerous parts of the game for an official, because sometimes sticks come up and get you in the face. So we do have protective equipment. Many people don't even know we have. In fact, the pants that I wear have built-in pads. In addition to what I wear under the pants, I have built-in pads in the pants. And the skates, of course, just like players, we wear the same skates as players. And the skates are hard shell or padded, and they provide a great deal of protection. Still hurts when a puck hits you, but they do provide a great deal of protection. I've been officiating for 12 years. So the first 2 years, I was a level 1, then I was a level 2. My third year, I became a level 3, and I remain a level 3, with no desire to go to level 4. Official is a very responsible position. You have to do something that probably 50% of the people there are going to be upset at what the decision you just made. If you feel you can handle that, then it's probably a good idea for you to try and become an official.